We'll see how to obtain patents. So once you have done your invention or research or new findings, which is now we can say a prototype or even a device. So that is, you have an invention. That invention, you will bring it to some of your colleagues or subject matter experts, your professor, your guide, and many times a patent agent or a patent attorney who is experts can also see, and they can judge the patent for its novelty, its market, and various things. It is worth of business value, or it is worth of some publication, we can say a patent to approach in maybe for future business to license by some other companies, then you can go for filing a patent. Then attorneys, agents, they will assess the invention for novelty and obviousness and even patentable subject matter, to such that you can go for grant of your patent will be granted also in coming years. The criteria for patentability, as I already told, novelty, novel or new things or new invention which was not available in previous or in past years or in anywhere in the world. So that will be called novelty or novel aspects of an invention or innovation or device. Then inventive step. If suppose I am doing a work of combining a TV and microwave oven, this is both working independently, just I am using it jointly as a one device, but it is just a mere combination. It can be done by anybody. So it does not involve any inventive step, as it is both the device are working independently and it can be done through just a routine joining of the two parts or the two devices. So it does not involve any skill, or it is obvious to a person skill. So it is not having any inventive step, or it is obvious to a person. So if it is obvious, a patent will not be granted. It should have some intellectual inputs involved, like some problem were there which has no solution. You use some technology to solve that problem. Suppose a TV was using very high voltage power, and you have made a TV which is using very low power or electricity, then that TV will have always advantage of economic significance and even technical advancement. So that TV will have worth rather than making it a big combination of thing. Then utility. If any device you prepared and it has no use, then also patent will not be granted to that. So always keep in mind that it should have some utility part in that. Your invention should always have utility. All these three criteria should be satisfied while for getting a granted patent. So novelty, it is a new invention, new product or process, not known anywhere in the world, first time you have made like this, and so it is a novel invention, novel part or novel product. That anticipation from any publication, if happens that some people have reported in their research thesis or in other countries they are using in other language for reporting, that can also destroy a novelty. But it has to be have all the features of the product in the document previously published. So if all the features are there, then it can be a novelty killing document. Or even commercial products which are the same feature as a patent, then also it will be novelty killing product. Inventive step is something, as I told, it should be having some economic significance or technical advancement. So we will see in detail here. Suppose we have made an invention from prior art. Prior art is one device, or one of the, we can take the example again of bottle. the prior bottle was very, very plain in its surface. So when we fill a water and that bottle was slippery, it was slipping from the hand. But after some creative inputs, the bottle design was changed from plain bottle to gripping bottle by providing striations in the body of the bottle. Some marks were there of striated marks, like for holding the bottle by fingers. So by that, it is providing a gripping effect of the bottle in our hand. So with that, we can say that it has a technical advancement in the bottle compared to the prior art. The requirement of chemicals for making that plastic bottle was very low, we can say. So it is also having economic significance. So like that, all the, in this technology, both the criteria are satisfied. Any one of the criteria if satisfied, it is having an inventive step. So patent will be granted to if satisfied one of the criteria of technical advancement or economic significance. Also, some creative input should be involved. It should not be obvious to the person skilled in the art. If it is just a routine work, then it is not inventive. It should have some solution to a problem which was not solved before. Then person skilled in the art. So if you are a subject expert, you can be called a person skilled in the art. If you can try a routine experiment and make a particular device, then that hypothetical person with in your field, if without any creative input, if he can make the device, then it is obvious to person skilled in the art. So this is very broad topic, but for your understanding, please take it that you should have at least satisfied technical advancement and economic significance. So by this, we can say, we can judge through the eye of person skilled in the art about obviousness or inventive step. Technical advancement. Technical solution to a problem. So one of the problem I told about TV consuming a lot of electricity. So if I have made a TV which is consuming very less power and which is giving me a lower electricity bill, then that is a solution of a TV consuming high power problem. So that is a technical solution to a problem, and it should always be better. New technology is very easy to use or easy to grasp or work with. If it is very complicated, no one will buy, so it is not technically better also. And also we should apply some of our skills or some of our creative inputs, scientific knowledge, to make or solve the problem, not just a simple experiment thing. And also it should be easy to store, manufacture and handling, etc. Economic significance. If one of the technology is which is providing a product at a very cheaper cost, then it has economic significance over the same product manufactured by other company at very higher prices. So the one who make it at very lower cost, their process or their procedure for manufacturing will be economic compared to the one selling at higher price and at very higher rate of for making the product. So by this, it will be called economic significance. Any technology falling or giving economic significance can have patent if it is satisfying a novelty criteria also. Then utility. If an industry is, your devices can be used in any industry, then it can have a patentable criteria. So it has some advantage or usage in industry, and it can be manufactured at industrial level. So all that thing can be, we can get. This is section 3 of Indian Patent Act, which is non-patentable subject matter. It is also criteria for patent, we can say. And it has listed what are the things which patents are not granted for. So we already discussed about discoveries, scientific theories, discoveries of new species in jungle. That is not patentable. Scientific theories and mathematical method. Theories like equations, as we know, E equal to mc square, force is equal to mass into acceleration. And these are just a formula. And it don't have any public use as such. So likewise, these are all don't get patents for. Then inventions contrary to public order. Like example is human cloning, a device for human injury. And all these things are not patentable. And plant varieties. Plant varieties, it come under Plant Varieties Act. And plant varieties, new plant varieties, they don't get patent in India. But in other countries, they have some provision for getting patent for new plant varieties. But in India, we don't have such provision. Second, use of compound. If suppose one of the compound is known for treatment of pain, suppose aspirin is there, it is used for as a painkiller. But after 10 years, 15 years, people have done a research on human body or in animals, and they found that aspirin is also used to lower the clot, blood clotting. So it can be used in heart patient and all. So that is the second use of a compound. In India, it is also not patentable, but in Europe and US, it is patentable. Then method of treatment. If you are using drug for treatment of a disease, only drug for treatment, then it is not patentable. But one, you have to just give a chemical as a new chemical or new product, then it is patentable. But as such, method of treatment in human or animal body, any drug or any medicine useful in diabetes and all, direct claim are not patentable as such. So I think it is clear now. So living things, they are discovery mostly, so they are also not patentable. Mathematical methods, calculations, equations, even e-commerce business, that it is just a platform to do business, so it is not patentable. Example, buying and selling of goods on website. Then computer programs, logic is there, that A to B, B to A, algorithms, then database. Logics and program, they are just a set of instructions. So they are instructions, they are not patentable as. If suppose we modified an animal for making them susceptible to disease or prone to disease, genetic engineering, that animal is getting cancer, that is also not patentable because it is contrary to public order. Then discovery, one of the example is microorganism as such available in nature, they are not patentable. If microorganisms, we have made some manipulations in its genetic makeup, then there are possibilities that microorganism can be patentable. Then frivolous inventions are contrary to well established natural laws, like perpetual motion, that is not possible as such, and it is frivolous, we can say. Then discovery of new form of known substance. New form is mostly it happens in pharma, that one of the form is crystals of a chemical is there, and some different crystal chemicals or polymer later on we found. So from that we can say new form is there, but in India it is not allowed. In other countries, if they provide some different solutions for that crystal or for that new form, they will get a patent. Then this literary, dramatic, artistic work or presentation of information, these are copyright part. They will get copyright on all these things, drama, music, all film things are in copyright. Even video, movies, they are mostly in copyrights. They file for songs and all. Then mere admixture of known compounds. Just mixing one and two colors if we add color to a juice, that color will not interact with the entire juice. So this is just a mere admixture and it is not patentable. Then integration of known components working in India. I told the example of TV and microwave oven. They are just keeping aside one after the other and they are working independently. They don't have any connection in between. So they are also not patentable. Then traditional knowledge. Traditional knowledge, previously some communities were using pigeon blood for paralysis treatment. These are very old knowledge reported in Indian books. So this traditional knowledge is also not patentable as it is already known in from people working in communal tribes. One more example of known components working independently is a fridge with fan placed on upper side. If a fridge is there and we have placed a fan on it and we are filing a patent, we will not get because both the devices are working independently. They don't have any connection in it. Atomic energy related inventions, they can be protected by some rights. It is decided by the government only. Then if it is method for playing chess, do you think it will be patentable? No, because it is involving some mind involvement only. Suppose instructions are there in board, various symbols are written, or various signals are in traffic signals, we say. So they are all instructions or signals, we can say. They are not patentable.